podcasts brought to you by Real Terryo Radio.
Hello, it's me, Dick Bachelor, and I'm feeling a bit worse for wear today. It's Boxing Day, and I got a terrible hangover. Last night, after I spoke to you, and that story, this is why I have to leave, I left you. I had a bit too much to drink. I ended up dancing with Mrs. Gupta's mother. We were singing Divine MCAs. Oh, I tell you, that woman can dance. Me and her have decided to go to New York City's, you know, Dancing Studio 54. But I don't know if it's open. We asked Gupta to pay. Well, Gupta's father. It turns out, when they die, Gupta gets everything. Oh, he's gonna be rich. 3 BMWs in the car, in the drive. So, where were we? No wonder why that bloody idiot, Jase, who's the bloody idiot of the world, wanted to marry my dear husband Gupta, isn't it? So I was telling you about my wedding to my dearest husband and love of my life, my 34th husband, Gupta Sanjeep Bachelor. Oh, I must remember to tell you about my sister. She's a nun. And her name is Sister Angelita. And she's currently got a child named Long Ming, who she wants us to adopt. Me and Gupta are thinking about it. But you never know. We do love this. And we believe in that the children should come first in everything we do. So, back to the wedding, to my dearest love, my 34th husband, and my last. I swear that maybe Gupta, that's Gupta Sanjeep Bachelor. So, that bloody idiot Jase Stones had locked himself in the diary rooms. You know, because he caused a fight. He made my uncles come. That's Uncle Old Mr. Bachelor and Young Mr. Bachelor. And they own the department stores Bachelor Brothers. Very good retail stock. They also live in the Channel Islands. And they believe in keeping their taxes for themselves and not allowing government to spend it on frivolous things like road mending and more MPs pay. I bet you Theresa Summers could have learned a lot from them. However, she's back in the nick. I also believe that my dear sister, Sylvia, and her repulsive little husband to be Malcolm. That's Malcolm Fennan, not Nichols. He's going to come back and have a chat. Well, someone better not tell Bobby Darren's, isn't it? Bobby Darren's, he's grown so much. He's Uncle Dick's favourite nephew. Him and my son, Victor Manuel, are made up. I'm very proud. And I'm very glad these weddings are for family times. However, I did slip Bobby Darren's £250,000 to keep Victor Manuel away from that Noel Moffat's daughter / whatever. Because we do not need these people in the family. If you remember, that bloody idiot Jase Stones is going to be that girl's stepfather. And that's even worse than the mother being a man. Now, so, Big Brother kicked bloody idiot Jase Stones out of the dining room. As he left, the security guards put him in a straitjacket and sat him down in the corner of the marquees so he could watch everything. My dear nephew, Bobby Darren, who's contemplating a career in the Roman Catholic Church as a priest. You know, all serving people decided to go over and give him some food and some water. Because he believes in helping people. and in charity. Well, that bloody fool, Jay Stones, bloody idiot, told Bobby Dallins all about what Malcolm has been doing to poor Sylvia, his mother. Now Bobby Darren didn't know what to do. Love him. He came to his Uncle Dick and told me what Jay Stone's bloody idiot had done. I said to Bobby, leave it to Uncle Dick. I will sort it all out and we'll never see Malcolm Fenner Nichols again. Trust me. I used to be in the Marines and I know very strong people. And I've never been caught for any of my crimes to date. I can swear on a lot of Bibles here. Next thing I know, Sylvia and Malcolm come in. Oh God, I thought it is going to all kick off here. So I went over to my uncles. That's Uncle Old Mr. Bachelor and Uncle Young Mr. Bachelor. And I inquired on where did they get the amphibious tank from? I said, Uncle Old Richard Bachelor, where did you get the tank from? He said, well, it was parked on our land in World War II and we commandeered it and then took a ride to our island in the Channel Islands, you know, to a house. And we kept it there ever since. We don't believe in giving stuff back when it's on our land, even if that neighbour boy next door kicks a football in the garden. We send Jorge out to get the football and then we put it under the stairs. We're not going to start giving back stuff now, even though it was an American tank that was amphibious. Well, they should have not packed it on our land, they said. So, next thing I know, Bobby Dallin had started walking over to Malcolm Sylvia. And he hugs Sylvia and gives her a kiss on the neck. Oh, well, on the cheek. It looked like the neck from where I was sitting, well, standing. But I haven't got my glasses on, so what can I do? And I must remember I was a bit pissed here. That bloody idiot Jay Stones has spoilt my dear wedding to my dear love, my 34th husband, Gupta Sanjeep Bachelor. So, next thing, as I looked over and they were hugging and kissing Sylvia and Bobby Dallins, that's Bobby Dallins, I then saw Bobby Dallins call Malcolm. He then raised his right arm like he was going to put his arms around him. Instead, he went for his neck and started strangling him. Then he took his hands away from his neck and punched him in the nose. Sheila, that's Gupta's wife Sheila, was a very good woman in a fight. Used to be middleweight champion for Aberdeen Girls. She jumped in. And she had a fight. She doesn't like this Malcolm chap from the fight earlier. She was on Bobby Darren's side. We must remember this. Even though I'm going to now give her a job as a toilet cleaner. So Malcolm was on the floor and poor Sylvia was crying. But don't worry, Bobby Darren, like a good boy, and my son Victor Manuel, took that Malcolm outside and put him in the rubbish. And Bobby Dallin then helped his mother into the tank and his two great uncles and took them back to the Channel Islands because Bobby Dallin said his mother needs to relax in peace away from these cameras. So after all of those interruptions and that bloody idiot Jay Stones causing all these troubles, I'm happy to report that the wedding of me and my dear beloved 34th husband, Gupta Sanjeep, went well. After that, me and Gupta cut up a rug a couple of times on the dance floor, and then we made intimate relations that were filmed all over the world, as if you remember from episode 4. Oh well, the things that you do. And then we went on our honeymoon to Amsterdam. But Not before getting that bloody idiot Jase on the job in my uncle's store. And is husband-to-be, because they now announced their engagement. Noel Moffat, who used to be named, I really can't remember. But don't worry about it. We'll have a long relationship with them, because, you know, my dear uncles, old Miss Batchelor, young Miss Batchelor, who don't get around much, enjoyed the excitement so much of riding around with Victor Manuel and Bobby Darlins that they decided to go on around the world cruise together, and they're going to take Bobby Darlins and Victor Manuel's with them. And they're leaving me in charge of all the businesses. Gupta's looking forward to it. He's already planning out his outfit for the Managing Director's Wives Club. Oh, dearly me, eh? And we're keeping Sheila on as our housekeeper. Well, she has some other responsibilities. She's now responsible predominantly for toilet scrubbings. But we also need good security, see? And as she is a Scottish Aberdeen Girls School medium weight champion, we must keep her on. And me and Gupta and the boys, and they invited my kids too, for New Year's in Scotland with Sheila's family. Graham Arbcastle, his name is. Mac Burns, good man. He found his money in industrial, being a ticket collector on the buses. Really. Driving people from there to here and go back and forth. Wouldn't Jay Stone's bloody idiot like him? So, we are looking forward to it. Now today, on St. Stephen's Day, Boxing Day, me and Gupta's family plan to have a turkey curry. I really wish that Mrs. Gupta's mother will learn to make Christmas dinner. So I invited them all next year to my house in the Caribbean. And we're going to have a traditional Caribbean Christmas dick dinner with all the trimmings, even Father Christmas on the beach. And this time I'm going to buy them all matching t-shirts with Christmas characters on, with for our 1 year anniversary, saying Dick's Family number 1/34. Remember, the 34 resembles 34 husbands, and the love of my life, Gupta, is number 34. So, I can't wait to see you on New Year and to tell you how our Scottish New Year's party goes. Thank you for tuning in, and we hope you have a Merry Christmas, Happy Boxing Days, and enjoying the sports. I'm going now to go and get more pissed with the family and the friends of Gupta. Oh God, none of them dealing me speak that much English. It's so hard on me. But me and Gupta's mother, like I said, are planning a trip to Studio 54 in New York, and we have become the best of friends. We even got the same taste in handbags. So I see you soon, peoples. Bye bye.
Broadcasting worldwide online 24/7.
Your real good feel, good online radio station. This is Real Terryo.